After we've purchased the SiteGround plan, we are redirected to the SiteGround dashboard at my.siteground.com. Here, we will see various options having to do with our account. As you can see as I'm scrolling down, we're going to focus on the most important thing right now, and that is to connect our domain to an actual installation. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Websites. And in the following screen, you can see that there currently is not a website in our account. So the logical step is to add a website. So we want to click here at the bottom where it says Create Website. Now, the moment that I do this, I am prompted with the next option, and that is to choose the domain. And that can be a new domain, an existing domain, or a temporary domain. But since we have already purchased our domain, we're going to click on Existing Domain and select that one. You can see from the moment that I've clicked on Existing Domain, we have the option to enter our domain name here at the bottom. So every day I'm traveling is the domain we said we're going to use. So as we click on Continue, we're going to see that indeed the domain we wish to use is not registered at our SiteGround account. So we have to make sure that in order to have access to this domain, we will need to update its DNS settings after we've created the site. But we're going to pretend that this has already been done, and we're going to click Continue anyway. Now, the next step is where we can actually start creating a new website. So Start a New Website is what we're going to select here. And as I click Select, I am prompted with a bunch of applications to choose from. Obviously, we're going to select the very first one, the WordPress application. So we select that one, and we are immediately prompted with an extra input field to set up my WordPress login. Once I've entered both my email address and password, the one I want to use for the administrator account for my WordPress site, I will click Continue. And the last step of the adding a new website wizard presents me with the option to also install or activate a SiteGround site scanner on my account. We're going to ignore that for now and just click Finish. Now, the next step is all happening behind the screens, and SiteGround is actually creating a fully installed WordPress installation for us. Once the SiteGround site installer has finished, we can click on Websites menu tab again, and then we can see here that everydayimtraveling.com is indeed connected to our hosting account. It displays the WordPress logo, so that means we have a WordPress installation ready at everydayimtraveling.com. So the next thing we're going to do is click on the button here at the right where it says WordPress Kit. Once I click that, I am presented with a bunch of tools that we can use. Our first job is to jump into the WordPress admin itself, so that's what we're going to do. We're going to enter our login credentials that we've created in an earlier step. From the moment we have started the login process, we are taken to a next wizard, and that wizard is called the WordPress Starter, and it will guide us through a few steps to welcome us to our WordPress website. So we're just going to click Start Now at the bottom. and we can choose different types of themes. We're not going to do that. We're going to stay with the default, in this case, 2017 theme. And the next step is us clicking on continue at the very bottom. Once I click continue, I am presented with a few other options. I can select a contact form. I can select a shop plugin if I need it, or a few other ones. I'm going to ignore what the other options are here and basically just hit continue and only select the contact form, as you can see. And the next step is probably the most important one, because here you have the option to optimize for SEO. So we're going to select that one. We're going to hit complete. And the installation is now in progress, meaning our WordPress installation is going to be prepared by the options we have selected in the past three steps. It's installing the theme. It's importing some sample data. And congratulations, our site is ready. So we have successfully completed the installations of everything that we selected. And the next step we're going to do is go to our dashboard. Now, this isn't the default dashboard. This is a specialized dashboard created by SiteGround, so your actual dashboard will look different. I'm just going to scroll down and see what's here. And I'm going to check one specific menu item here where it says SG Optimizer, which stands for SiteGround Optimizer. We're going to click on that and see what type of options we have here. Now, the most important one for now is the environment optimization, because we do want to make use of HTTPS. That is a more secure way of serving your website to visitors. This will force HTTPS. That is exactly what we want. So we're going to hit confirm. And now HTTPS is available. Next step is go back to the dashboard. And for that, we need to log in once more. And now we're done.